He is larger than the reasoning, rational mind to comprehend.
It's beyond death and birth, like the Buddha's mind is absolute and cannot be affected.
Society doesn't know what to do with a person like him because he doesn't follow traditional social conventions by any means, so that's why he ends up getting burned at the stake.
Numerous times he was kicked out of places he had been brought to teach, other times he was punished.
It's kind of like dealing with dynamite. So he's kind of like dynamite to the mind. As a second Buddha, his life is about in great contrast to the historical Buddha of anyone you could possibly fathom. He's not sitting quietly in a deep state of meditation under a tree. He's actually out there and he's working with wild and wrathful spirits and he's making love to wonderful princesses.
Долдуур зөвний үед Лом Бадамжуна бурхан төвдөд морилоод шашныг дэлгэрүүлж өч хар тэнгэрүүтэйг бол номонд орсон. А тэр цагта мөн адил төв азын өргөн удам нутгийн лус авдаг тэнгэрч төрүүдийг бас номонд орсон тийм домогтой.
The belief was there were a lot of wild and dangerous spirits here, and Guru Rinpoche was the only one that was really able to transform those kind of spirits into becoming allies or protectors. And so his message of transforming that which is dark, even within our own psyches, I think is a message that still is really alive today.
Buddha predicted that he would not teach a certain number of teachings. Time was not ripe, and being born from a human womb, he would only teach the sutras and like that. So then he predicted that someone will come from immaculate birth and vastly give the teaching of the tantras.
The power of Guru Rinpoche lies in his inclusivity. There's no discrimination in that mind, and in its absence of sense of right and wrong, good and bad, he includes the whole universe, and in that universe, he is the mainspring of every possible form of energy.
Guru Rinpoche used to say, that a woman, if she had the right kind of mind, had a greater potential for realization than a man in a men's body. And this is pretty radical in 8th century, if we try to look around at how women were understood and perceived at that time period.
Bedmasong Bo was medicine very powerful before practice many. I'm meditation before 100,000 mantra. I'm counting night, day, no sleep, all the mantra together. Sticking out, and I'm like this mantra, put inside. This some treatment. This Bedmasong Bo system. Treatment another patient, very bad, you know, some naga, some very bad injured. Medicine, no work. Then this mantra powers.
Guru Rinpoche blessed the major caves of central Tibet, or the whole of Tibet, by his presence, by his meditation. And almost without exception, those great Guru Rinpoche caves were high up at the, on the Pu, on the top of the valley with an outlook which is more or less mandalic in form. They are the natural places for meditation.
When great beings meditate in a place, when they spend time in a place, their energy comes into that environment. Their energy lingers there like a Tibetan expression is like a sweet sandalwood fragrance.
Term is a treasure, term is a revelation. Guru Rinpoche said he was going to hide these treasures in order that communities in different times, in different places, could receive an appropriate teaching and practice.
There are 18 kinds of dharmas, but broadly, there are material dharmas, like objects, and there are earth dharmas, like hidden concealed in the casket or stone. There is mind dharmas, there is sky dharmas, and myself the great fortune to be this humble student of at least three major treasure revealers. It is not mythical stories. I mean, they reveal countless treasures, and I know them. I've seen some of their treasure. I received their transmissions. I mean, there's no way that these people will just tell lies to people.
Guru Rinpoche Semedi Dipapra Pansasa Yisim Tantri Sim Giranji Yisi Totopra Ra Sangika Ragi Nubachika Domdingwe Te Chunchim Gi Machelu Lamtunzi Chui Shik Nami Nuba Yumigi Te Lamchulu Nuzimbu Yinzi.
Obstacles are totally undesirable, but they happen no matter what. So it's not that, as some people say, we need to suffer. We will suffer anyway, don't worry about that. But then the point is, once suffering is there, which it will be, or obstacles, whatever you call them, then the way you deal with that makes a huge difference.
The root cause of the samsara is ignorance, and all this with it is ignorance. Many negative emotions arises. The antidote, or in order to overcome these negative emotions, we need a positive emotions like love, kindness, compassion, altruistic intentions.
What we are looking for is the experience that gives us a key to an understanding of the nature of being. And we can find that in all kinds of places. In culture, it's been sexual experience, natural experience, all kinds of experience. You can find that key, you identify that key. That becomes Guru Rinpoche. That becomes your touchstone.
Do you think in human evolution, when humans discovered fire, and it could either destroy us or it became one of our most powerful tools? So in that sense, I believe that if people really are interested individually to explore within their own psyches, what does Guru Rinpoche mean? That will be the revolution and transformation.